pray that I might have the grace to let you be my servant too. We are pilgrims on a journey. We are brothers on the road. We are here to help each other walk the mile and bear the load. I will weep when you are weeping. When you laugh, I'll laugh with you. I will share your joy and sorrow till we've seen this journey through.
When we sing to God in heaven, we shall find such harmony. Born of all we've known together, a Christ love and agony.
Good morning, Holy Spirit, for your grace to commit ourselves in doing God's work. Lord God, we worship you for all the victories you accomplish in our lives and in your church. O Spirit of the Most High God, empower us to faithful do your will in Jesus' name. Beloved, throughout the year, how was your commitment to God, your family, your job, duties as a worker, and your commitment to the people in your community? Human effort usually fail in our relationship with God and neighbors, as well as institutions we are called to serve. Energies usually drain away easily, and we become weary and buried on. Therefore, not by might, nor by power, but by Spirit, says the Lord God Almighty. As Zechariah chapter 4 verse 6 encourages us with, you and I need to become energized and get more strength from God in order to faithfully commit to the marriage, the relationships, work, financial management, or contributing his or her portion towards the bills in the home, and even commit to the romance and love making. Friends, to some folks, commitment was a big problem, both in ministry and marriage, especially this year. Honestly, if you are not committed, don't get into the relationship and marry the person or take up a responsibility in the church or in the job, or be committed to your responsibility. Beloved, ideas for action will always come from the willingness to obey the word of God, and the fact that you are rooted in Christ. Some, instead of being committed, will give all kinds of excuses to escape responsibility. Your mind, instead of being the playground of God, becomes the playground of the devil, causing you to be lazy and unfaithful in the use of your gift talents and your God-given special abilities. Beloved, make a decision to work with God. Work with God and live your life like that, committing your time, talent, and treasure as a living sacrifice to God. Don't say my daily schedule is so tight or crowded with personal activities, therefore, not enough time for my spiritual development or your spiritual development, let alone God's work. Instead, by the grace of God, resolve to become an agent of change, a tool of love, comfort, and encouragement for all, especially the needy. That should be your zeal of influence. While trusting God to empower you each day of the week, knowing that God has anointed you as his vessel, a blessing to your generation. Stay blessed and good morning. Bye for now.
My servant.